City of Warangal is the second largest city in the province of Telangana, in the state of Telangana, after Hyderabad. The population is about close to a million. Being a million plus city, it has no underground sewerage system. There's no underground sewerage system, with almost 35% of open defecation when we started our work. That was in 2014-15. And there were a lot of insanitary toilets discharging directly into the drains. And the whole desludging process of these septic tanks and pits were totally unregulated, and the waste was discarded in water bodies. The city has about 40 plus drinking water bodies which are used for potable and non-potable applications, and they were getting contaminated because of the disposal of septage. And there was no regulation at the city level, both from containment, how to construct a toilet. There were no capacities in terms of what are the design standards. There was no regulation in terms on the private sector who were doing the desludging, and the waste was disposed quietly, you know, in an erratic manner across the length and breadth of the city, based on the availability of space. And so that was the context within which the work has started. And the first thing that we started off with is to think through strategically in terms of what should be the vision for the city. And the consultative processes led to a common understanding that the city should look at approaches of non-sewer sanitation than look at a sewerage system, for the simple reason that there was, one is a cost implication, second is a lack of availability of water supply to drive the sewerage system, and also openness to look at disruptive technology solutions rather than a very conventional hydraulic reticulated models. So the city was open to looking at alternate approaches, and that led to a common understanding that yes, let's look at non-sewer sanitation.
So the first thing was this?
This was in 2015-16. Okay. So this was the work has we stepped in the city around 2015, and then the consultation processes, the diagnostic, the advocacy was for a 6-month period between 15-16. That's a time period we are talking about. So the city, first thing the city did in 2016 was to introduce what is called the fecal sludge management regulation. This was not a national drive, this was not a state drive, but the city took a conscious decision through their own council resolution that yes, this sector needs regulation. This is one area that we need to carefully regulate, both from containment all the way to treatment and disposal, including conversion of insanitary toilets to sanitary toilets. Okay. So that's a time, is the first, I would say, the first city in the country, in India, to have introduced FSM regulation at the city level. Subsequently, the national policy came out, and many states have introduced statewide policy and regulatory framework. But City of Warangal started off with this exercise. Following that regulation, which was a driving force for the subsequent work, the first thing that city did was to look at enhancing access. Access was a big issue in the city because of lack of access to toilets, lack of access to individual as well as public conveniences. So the city went on with leveraging the Swachh Bharat program, the Clean India program, taking advantage of the program which triggered off at the same time. It started providing individual toilets, and they have established what is called a sanitation helpline, which basically to a single point interface for urban poor and everybody else to access an individual household sanitation provision as made available under Swachh Bharat Clean India program.